I was getting promoted to captain when I was deployed.
And you still love your country, don't you?
Absolutely.
A career intelligence officer, Grusch spent time on the ground in Afghanistan and other places he can't mention before rotating back to Washington.
I was an intel officer for the U.S. for 14 years. My last position, which I left in April of 2023, I co-led the UAP portfolio for the National Geospatial Intelligence Agency, and some of the highest officials within the Department of Defense and Intelligence Community used to call on me to advise them on some of the hardest target sets that the country had.
You are one of the most trusted former intelligence officials in the U.S. defense and intelligence establishment.
Yes, I was.
You were trusted with the most intimate secrets.
Yes.
And he says the most earth-shattering of those secrets were revealed after 2019, when he was invited to join the UAP task force.
You had the security classifications to go anywhere and ask anyone anything.
I had, based on my formal security clearance and multiple polygraphs, I had the ability to be read into any program that I needed. At one point in time, I was extremely highly cleared.
What conclusion did you come to at the end of your time on the UAP task force?
The UAP task force was refused access to a broad crash retrieval program.
When you say crash retrieval, what do you mean?
These are retrieving non-human origin technical vehicles, you know, call it spacecraft if you will, non-human, exotic origin vehicles that have either landed or crashed.
We have spacecraft from another species.
We do, yeah.
How many?
Quite a number.
You're kidding.
No. I thought it was totally nuts, and I thought at first I was being deceived. It was a ruse. People started confiding in me. They approached me. I have plenty of current and former senior intelligence officers that came to me, many of which I knew almost my whole career, that confided in me. They were a part of a program. They named the program. I've never heard of it. And they told me, based on their oral testimony, and they provided me documents and other proof, that there was, in fact, a program that the UAP task force was not read into.
Grusch says he's never personally seen non-human intelligence, but he's spoken to enough people directly involved in what he calls the program that he's convinced it's real.
I started out as a non-believer. I came to the problem as a hardcore physics guy, intel officer. So I have a, you know, excuse my language, high factor. I was very methodical, interviewing people who didn't know each other, making sure this wasn't some kind of cover-up of some other program.
He says he pressed to gain direct access to this program, and that's when his trouble started. Grusch claims his investigation was stymied, his requests for access rebuffed.
They shut the door in my face. They denied me access to these programs.
Soon after, he says, he endured reprisals and retaliation from above. He then reported that information to the Intelligence Community Inspector General. That's why he's filed this whistleblower complaint. He says that experience is why he decided to go public here, and in a recent article written by Leslie Kane in The Debrief.
You're not being paid for this interview?
No, I'm not.
Why are you doing this?
It's a sense of service, you know? Call me a Boy Scout or whatever. It just, when I saw the kind of wrongdoing I did, I don't want to be 60, 70 years old in the future and have that, you know, coulda, shoulda, woulda kind of feeling where I could have made a difference. I did not want to live a life of regret.
You are saying to the human race, for the first time, an official intelligence representative at a high level from the US government is saying publicly, we are not alone.
We're definitely not alone. Absolutely, the data points empirically that we're not alone, yeah.
You've said that we have, the United States has spacecraft, intact craft.
We do.
Do we have bodies? Do we have species of...
Well, naturally, when you recover something that's either landed or crashed, sometimes you encounter dead pilots. And believe it or not, as fantastical as that sounds, it's true.
Have you seen spacecraft?
I've seen some interesting photos and I've read some very interesting reports.
But well-spoken ex-military intelligence officer who just happens to have lost his mind.
Do you have any kind of mental illness?
No.
Have you ever had a psychosis, a delusion?
No.
Is there anything in your medical history that might be capable of being interpreted as a reason why you might be confabulating, making
no,
things up?
No, I'm not a disgruntled employee. I resigned on my own accord because I thought altruistically it's more appropriate to show thought leadership on the outside on this now, because I, you know, hit an impasse within the government to try to right this wrong.
So I've got to be blunt about this. Yeah. You're not making this up. This is not a lie.
No, absolutely not.
Because everybody watching this right now is looking at your face. Mm-hmm. They're going, is this guy for real?
I am for real. And I'm, you know, I'm sitting here at great personal risk and obvious professional risk by talking to you today.
You've told us that we really are not alone. Even though you believe what you say is true, you haven't been fed disinformation. It's a common thing in intelligence for governments to mislead.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was very sensitive to that fact. You know, was this some kind of ruse against me? Am I being used in any kind of way? And I took about 4 years being very methodical before I filed my whistleblower complaint to be absolutely certain of these basic facts.
Yeah. So that's my long story. Yeah.
The biggest complaint I'm hearing out there, and just to get it out, people are saying, why don't we have, you know, the documents? Why don't we have the direct evidence? I mean, do you think we can look forward to the possibility of seeing? Do you think there'll be transparency eventually if it comes to that?
Sure. But I mean, again, Dave Grusch didn't get to leave with documents and photos.
Right.
You know, when he walked out of the Pentagon on bad terms, basically, they're not loading him up with suitcases and hard drives. That's not how it works. Now,
but do you think it will lead to
it? To go to these Senate. To the Senate and the House and the Inspector General, because they do have the classification, right? Mm. And he was able in some way, shape, or form to turn them on to documents and other evidence. And it will be up to the people in our nation who make the decisions about classification, which is a hot topic right now, to decide what of that can or cannot be declassified into a public hearing. But it's not up to Ross Coulthart or Leslie Kane or Ralph Blumenthal, and it's not even up to Dave Grusch. I mean, he's done what he's done, the best a guy in his position can do. And I, my